Admiral Mike Mullen said over the weekend that the United States has never been as close as it is now to nuclear war. Do you agree with him?
Yeah.
Hopefully we'll go in the very, very peaceful, beautiful path. We're prepared to go whichever path is necessary.
The Bulletin of Atomic Scientists have used the Doomsday Clock to assess the world's risk of annihilation since 1947. As of January 25th, 2018, it's 2 minutes to midnight, the closest to doomsday it's ever been. It fell to 3 minutes in 2016, partly due to the world's collective inaction on climate change. Since Donald Trump's inauguration, the clock has counted down a full minute, mostly thanks to escalating tensions between North Korea and the US. Trump and Kim Jong-un now say they'll meet, and experts aren't sure how it will go. But let's remember the stakes. The impact wouldn't just be mass casualties. It also changed the planet in some pretty dramatic ways. A nuclear winter is the post-apocalyptic nightmare scientists have warned us about since the 1980s.
And most people don't know what nuclear winter is, or they think it was disproven, or they think that the number of weapons is so low it can't happen, but none of those are true.
And the same people who warned us over 30 years ago, their message hasn't changed.
This is truly a civilization-ending event, and it conceivably could lead to the extinction of humans as a species.
Here's one way it could go down. North Korea fires an intercontinental ballistic missile. The US retaliates, but due to a miscalculation, Russia's hit. Events snowball, and Russia and the US go to war, deploying the world's two largest nuclear arsenals. Each side strategically drops bombs, killing hundreds of millions of people. Those who remain will experience a sort of climate change on steroids. Massive firestorms, up to 1,000 times more powerful than the bombs that started them, erupt. DC and Moscow and other major cities burn. And there's so much smoke that it travels across the entire globe and stays trapped in the stratosphere for at least a decade. This blocks out the sun, leading to twilight at noon. Temperatures drop below freezing, even in the summertime. Rainfall is significantly reduced and crop growing seasons shorten dramatically.
When you have a failure year after year for plants to be able to grow, eventually the whole ecosystem collapses.
Once survivors finish off the roughly 2.5 months worth of global food storage, they face starvation. Ecosystems eventually begin to replace themselves some 20 years later, but we likely won't be around to see it. But back to the doomsday clock, that symbol of the rather scary times we're living in. Ever wonder why it was made in the first place? Its creators were actually nuclear scientists who built bombs during World War II. Even they wanted to warn the world of the dangers of nuclear war. The nuclear experts I spoke to scared me pretty badly, but they also reminded me of something pretty important. People power, science, and democracy. They've all turned back the hands on the doomsday clock before.
That message coming from American and Russian scientists to Reagan and Gorbachev helped convince them to end the nuclear arms race. So it was very empowering to have science affect policy.
Sure, there's no accounting for this guy, especially with the new $1 trillion nuclear push. Things look bleak. But I believe what the experts have been telling us all along. If we listen to the scientists and exercise our political power, we can make sure the clock never strikes midnight.
We've been given the opportunity to save the world. I hope that people will see that and act on it. And if they do, I think this story can have a happy ending.